Hello again, my name is Erik, and welcome to Cafe Calculations. Today I'm going to be talking about the commutative law of arithmetic and multiplication, but I also show how it works with division and subtraction, or does it work in this case. Once again, this is a spin-off or the next step from our conversation last time on a priori knowledge. Commutative law over addition and multiplication is one of the first foundational blocks that set up the rules for all the mathematical stuff that we're going to do in the future. As things get more complex and things get inserted in themselves and so forth with the algebras and calculus and so forth. So the first thing I want to point out to everybody or remind everybody, or maybe you don't know, math is a language, just like English, Korean, Chinese, Spanish, and so forth and so forth. But math has a slightly different capabilities. You wouldn't necessarily sing a song in mathematics. It doesn't hold emotion very well. But mathematics gives you this predictive ability. It allows us to predict and infer things that we could never do without. Math also has an interesting property that it can work left to right and right to left. So you can read it both ways. Conventionally though, we read left to right, but when you're working out the math, you can work right to left or left to right, but at the end we kind of put it in left to right just to kind of keep things neat. So the commutative law is a law I'm sure most people have heard in grade school and junior high and high school and college. It pops up all the time. But it's worth reviewing to kind of brush off the dust and really understand what it means. So I'm going to give you a few examples. First, it's going to be a general example. And just personally, in general means accounting for all cases of any numbers or any type of thing. And then a specific case where I pull a specific number or numbers and show how it works or doesn't work in this case. So let's talk about the commutative law first over multiplication and addition, or addition and multiplication. Now, a little side note, really multiplication is another form of addition, just like division is another form of subtraction, just in case somebody you may have not realized that. So let's talk about the commutative law in general, what this means. So what do I mean by that? I mean, in general, the commutative law, if I have some number A, and right now I'm just thinking numbers in the real number system. So from negative infinity all the way to positive infinity. Now there's other systems of numbers, but we're talking about this one. This is the most common one most people know, and this one we're going to talk about first and how these laws or axioms hold. So if I have some number A, and I want to add it to another number, let's call it B. Now these could be all numbers, but we'll omit zero. It'll work for zero, but that'll come in the next video. But let's just say A and B are some integers, some plus or minus, whatever it may be. That is going to equal also B plus A. And it's that simple. So it means this, if I take something A plus B, it is the same operation as doing it B plus A. The mathematics says it doesn't matter which way you do it. That's the commutative law over addition. Now let's look at the same thing over multiplication, because you remember I said that multiplication was another form of addition. So let's try it. If I have A times B, that is also equal to B times A. That's the commutative law over multiplication. Therefore, it doesn't matter what order you multiply things. You're going to get the same result. Now, that may seem trivial at a very, you know, simple case we're taking right now, but later on in math and in algebra and calculuses, and hopefully people go on, you'll find that you may be multiplying functions, you may be multiplying expressions, and it's not intuitive that they would make sense that way, especially as things get more complex. But when you boil it all down and distill it back to its original components, A times B is the same as B times A, as well as A plus B is the same as A plus B. Sorry. So that's the commutative law in general. Let's look at a case, a specific case now. Once again, these may seem trivial, but it's good to brush off the dust in mathematics so you really get the understanding of the axioms, because the axioms are where we derive, quote unquote, the mathematical power to wield the mathematics and really kind of develop that crystal ball and whatever it is that we're trying to measure. So let's try a case here. So I'm going to say 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2. Let's check it. Well, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. All right, let's look at the other side. 3 plus 2 also equals 5. Check. Works out. Let's try the multiplication case. Same numbers. 2 times 3 is equal to 3 times 2. This is what the law states. 2 times 3 is 6, and 3 times 2 is also 6. Checks out. Now, let's look at the cases for the subtraction and division and see what happens. All right, so let's keep the same consistency. 2 minus 3, we'll say, assume, we're going to assume, is equal to 3 minus 2. Let's check it. 2 minus 3, negative 1. All right. 3 minus 2, 1. Negative 1 does not equal 1. The property of commutative does not hold over subtraction. Let's check the division. Okay, so I'll use the same integers but in a division form. 2 over 3, we'll assume, will equal 3 over 2 if the law holds. All right, 2 over 3 is 0.66666 repeating. And the other side, 3 over 2 is 1.5. Clearly doesn't it exist. Once again, the division law does not hold for the commutative as well, or the commutative law does not hold over addition. Okay, so that's the commutative law over addition and multiplication, which it holds, and I showed also it does not hold over division and subtraction. Thank you very much for watching Caffey Calculations, and I hope to see you in the next video. Merry Christmas and enjoy the process.